Hello, this is a 2017 MacBook Air, and this machine is special because it is one of the last upgradable Macs. You can upgrade the storage, the SSD card. That's what I'm going to do today. I have this 970 Evo Plus Samsung 1TB. It's going to give this machine a lot more space to work with. Let's get into it. This is a step-by-step process video with some troubleshooting of errors that you might encounter when doing this. For this upgrade, you will need to order an SSD of your choice. I ordered a Samsung 1TB. This SSD also requires a small adapter to work with MacBook Air. Pay attention to the pin shape of this adapter to learn what fits into the MacBook Air. You will also need a MacBook screwdriver set. MacBook has six-pointed star screws. Everything you need for this upgrade is provided in the description below. Step 1 is to unscrew all of the screws on the bottom of the MacBook Air. Be sure to keep the screws in a safe place because they are very small and can easily get lost. Make sure you are on a static-free surface because we will be disconnecting and reconnecting the battery. Once all of the screws are removed, you can remove the back panel of the MacBook Air. You might see years of dust that have collected in your MacBook Air. You can buy a multi-purpose air duster to clear out the components and the fan. Step 3 is to remove the battery connector. Pull the tab gently to disconnect. This is the SSD that came with the Mac that will be changed. Here is a six-pointed star screw. Find your six-pointed star screwdriver to unscrew it. Now with the screw out of the way, you can gently lift up and pull it out. This is the new SSD. You can see how the pins on the new SSD and the old SSD are different, which is why an adapter on the new SSD is necessary. The adapter comes in this little bag. You can see how the adapter has the same shape as the old SSD. There is a disclaimer for this adapter. Each adapter is tested, but if you find that your device does not register the new SSD, it could be that the adapter is faulty. Step 4 is to place the adapter onto the new SSD. And insert the adapter carefully into the socket in the MacBook. Find the screw for the SSD and screw it in so that it is nice and snug. And now we need to reconnect the battery. Gently pull the tab and insert it back into the slot. Cover up the back panel. There is no need to replace the screws just yet because we might find that the SSD might not be properly inserted. Make sure your computer is plugged in and power on. The first error you can encounter is the question mark folder. It says support.apple.com/mac/startup. In order to get around this error, we're going to power off the computer, and then we're going to press Command, R, and power at the same time to enter recovery mode. Now we follow the setup. Choose your Wi-Fi network and put in your Wi-Fi password so that your MacBook can connect to the Wi-Fi. My computer indicates that it's going to take 23 minutes.
This is the old SSD, which was Apple approved, and this also supports the existing battery life that was mentioned for this MacBook Air. So because we're putting in a new one, it has been said that the battery life will now go down quicker, but that's okay since I'm going to be using this computer at home mostly.
After the world finishes, it goes to the Apple page and then it takes you to the setup page. So we're going to click on reinstall Mac OS and follow the menu prompts. This error is the untrusted cert title error. In order to get around this error, we need to click on utilities and then open the terminal. In terminal, type in date and press enter.
So the date is December 31st, 2019. That is not the current date. So we're gonna have to fix the date. So we're gonna type in NTP date space minus U space time.apple.com.
Press enter.
And now it says step time server, February. Very good. And press date again. February 16th. So that is the current date. So now we're going to go back to the Mac OS install.
You can restart and then press Command R to see the menu. You can always press Command Q to take you back to the menu with the disk utility. Now it is necessary to format the new SSD with disk utility so that it can work with Mac.
Selecting the new drive, we're going to click Erase. Format is going to be Mac OS Extended Journaled. I'm going to name this
New TB.
Mac OS Extended Journal, GUID partition map, this is the standard. So we're going to click Erase.
Formatting done.
Now we see the new TB here. Now we're going to press again, Command Q, which takes us back to this window, and we're going to reinstall macOS Big Sur. Continue. The Terms and Agreements menu has appeared. Select the new TB. Look at that. Continue. 44 minutes remaining. Okay. Mine just provided an update. It says about 4 hours and 27 minutes remaining. Just to give you an idea of what yours should take, mine has taken 4 hours.
After about 2 hours of downloading macOS, it gave me this error. This operation couldn't be completed. Download error. 8. This happened because my power went out on my street in the middle of installation and the Wi-Fi cut out. This error can occur during installation of macOS Catalina if the internet connection is interrupted or disconnected. Make sure that Mac has an active Wi-Fi connection and that the internet works, and then try to install macOS Catalina again.
Do this process one more time. Select the new drive, continue. 44 minutes remaining.
Once you have made it to this menu page, you are home free. Just follow the menu prompt and set up your MacBook as you like. Hooray, this is such a nice sight. It is like a new computer. Even though the Mac is now 6 years old, by upgrading the storage, you give it new life and it can work excellently as a backup computer or your main computer. The webcam works well and quite clear for Zoom meetings and can also download gaming software like Unreal Engine. Unfortunately, we cannot upgrade the memory. It is currently at 8 gigs, but the storage is at 1 TB, and this is excellent for storing lots of videos, photos, and applications. Thank you so much for watching this video, and please subscribe to this channel to support its growth.